sent a first copy of the book to Mr. Shyam Benegal.
Maithili, please stand up. Maithili, stand up. Maithili, stand up. Maithili, stand up.
We also have my mother's father joining us, Mr. Shivaji Patil.
Had my deepest apologies for being late this evening. There was a deep-rooted controversy that was hatched on the highway today, and they succeeded in breaking my tradition of arriving punctually at almost all functions, so I do hope you will excuse me. I always fall short of words whenever I have to speak about Smita and association with me and with the industry. From the very first moment that we came to know of her was through her face on television, and there was always something very unusual about the way she presented herself, about the way she looked, about the way she conducted her life. And when I had the great opportunity to work with her, I realized so many other things that were extremely, extremely unique about Smita. Smita looked very frail and gentle, almost as frail as some of the wonderful flowers that she used to bring to me when I had my accident. But she was a strong woman, extremely strong, very committed to not just her work but into her beliefs, in what she believed was right and what was wrong. Some of the things that she did in cinema with me were totally against her nature. Particularly a film like Namak Halal, where she had to do a rain dance with me, and she felt it was absolutely away from her culture and thinking, but because it was contracted to do something, we had to go ahead with it. And all the time I used to keep reassuring her that everything will be fine. And then I think a month or two after the film released, we happened to be in the same city, and we met up. And she said, "You know, Amitabh, I've worked in so many good films, great cinema." Having a sense of premonition, she was a dear friend of mine. We worked together in some very important films. But other than meeting her on sets, I never really had a social equation with her. And so when I was shooting for my film Coolie in Bangalore, one night, very late, almost 2 o'clock in the morning, the hotel receptionist called and said, "You have a phone call, sir, and would you like to take it?" So I said, "It's really late and I have to get up early." "Who is it?" They said, "It's Smita Patil." And this was a shock to me, because I had never ever spoken to her on the phone. Neither had she called nor I called her. And I had my accident in Coolie. And I cannot but think of those moments when Smita had this premonition about something going wrong with me. I've read through some of the portions of this book, and I must congratulate you, Maitriji, for really putting across the book in a great amount of elegance and in eloquence as well. There are portions which have been very deeply researched, and many of you who did not know her, as did Maithili, did not know her, she has put together something which will give an indication of who and what Smita Patil really was. I'm going to read a few portions of this book a little later, but these are some of the words that I remember today about Smita. She was ill during a time when I was about to travel to Mauritius, and I finished very late at night here as a great human being. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Mr. Bachchan. Mr. Benigal, a few words from you.
Let's get you seated.
That's very, very
Hello?
We'll be meeting later.
Of course.
Actually, we'll get the
chair behind the chair.
चलिए आगे चलिए
We should